Sid E. Hi. God damn, it's nice. Okay. So yeah, kind of going back to the DMCA stuff. Since I've done, people in our community have done so much programming, Twitch related and streaming related. I was kind of wondering if I can make my own scanner. Obviously, other people have done it. I might do a little bit more research and see if I can somehow do that myself. Because that would be cool. And I don't have to rely on other people, and I don't like relying on other people. So here's what we finished last night on the second channel. Everything's wrapped up. Some of these aren't in boxes because we might pull computer parts out of them on Sunday if my house internet proves to be stable enough. I'm going to put together my normal stream servers and use them to run the broadcast instead of paying for the Amazon EC2 cloud, even though the Amazon cloud works perfectly. But if I can run it myself, I'll save about $200 a month. And if I'm going to stay in this apartment for about 6 months, at least I have it reserved for. 200 times 6, that's $1,200. So if I want to save $1,200, I can put that computer together. Two. That would be nice. And we'll get some champagne. We'll buy a $200 bottle of champagne for the first month. Chat overlay is double. Thanks. I don't know why this didn't happen yesterday. Or maybe no one said anything. It's got clothes. I put like winter clothes in there. I have bed comforters. I have wintertime bed comforters. I have summertime bed comforters. I have a bed. Bedding. But I don't need that right now. Sometimes I need it. Not every apartment I go to has this stuff. I got costumes, cosplay stuff. At least two cases are full of computer equipment and like two complete desktops. So I got monitors for those desktops. It's not like I'm just like bringing around t-shirts or something or toys that I can't let go. Most of it's stream equipment, man. Or the hard to replace living stuff like bed sheets, that kind of stuff. Okay, let me take a look at what Hayes was saying with double overlays. Must have to do with the Amazon server side. Yeah, that looks pretty weird. Okay. Okay. I just reloaded it. Looks like it was only on that OBS scene.
Yeah, nice.
So, yeah, I started to transition the entire setup so that we can run it from those computers and kind of incorporate it to what's here now. So, I think that works good. Looks good, man. I just need to add 6 cats to look like a hoarder? Dude. Take a picture of your house for me right now. Tell me, does everything you own fit into like 8 suitcases, like what I have on the balcony? Everything you own? Yes. Yes. Dude, are you a hobo or something? What the fuck? Nothing against hobos. I'm basically at the point of living in cardboard boxes too. But let's be real. Your life, your entire life does not fit into just a couple of suitcases. That's not true. Anyone who says so is lying. There's a difference between traveling light and then just living. Anyone can travel light, but there's no way. What about your bed sheets and your pillows and stuff, man? Like I got pillows. I got like 4 pillows. I only brought one out of the suitcase for now, but like, I've lived in houses that didn't come furnished, and then I had to buy all the pillows. And now I just keep them with me because sometimes I have pillows on my bed, and sometimes I don't. Like, the last 3 months, I didn't have a bed, so I needed the pillows. You're a nomad? The oasis is burning up. We gotta keep moving. Okay. I don't believe you guys 1 second. You're all really bad liars, okay? All right, let's get the board. There's the Domino's pizza. Glad I got to try it once, but yeah, I probably won't buy that Domino's again. Okay, I'm missing something. My phone. You're my everything, and you could fit into one luggage. Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, my question on Discord before I fell asleep was if these DMCA strikes are such a problem on Twitch at this moment, especially for a lot of big broadcasters, why doesn't Twitch just come out and say, hey, we won't ban your account for the time being while these evil corporations are looking to fuck everyone over. We'll have to delete any content that is found by them. People wouldn't be shitting their pants if that was the case. And it seems a little bit normal. Like, that's what a normal person would do. What's happening is not normal. I blame it on coronavirus. And it's... this is, like, all related to coronavirus. The Black Lives Matter marching is related to coronavirus. People are at home with nothing to do. And so it's, like, the perfect time to get up and rally behind something because we're all pissed off and, like, cooped up. Which is great. Great time for revolution. But at the same time, you got these programmers working for evil corporations and companies with nothing to do at the moment. So, like, they're just doing this shit. Only someone with nothing to do would be doing this. Because, getting Twitch streamers banned doesn't make them any money. Not directly, anyway. It's not like YouTube, where if they detect their song in your video, then all the money goes to them. That's not happening. Like, it's people's livelihoods on the line, man. People are, especially right now with coronavirus, like, for people who have been doing this and streaming for years and use it as their main source of income now, to then lose it because of some copyright strikes. During coronavirus season, when there are no other jobs to get, like, that is so fucked, man. That is the definition of evil right there. And that was a really big problem for me a couple years ago when I was being targeted by Twitch and whatnot, like when they had turned off my channel without a reason, and then I lawyered up and then they turned my channel back on because they realized they couldn't legally do what they did. Like, that's affecting our livelihoods. Can't just do that. I'm gonna bring my helmet this time. I forgot it yesterday. Enjoy the last day of the week in the sun. Oh no. I don't really know if this is some kind of monsoon season or not. Like, monsoon season in June? Weird. In Taiwan, the monsoon season is in January. In Malaysia, it's in like November or something. Is that right?
Twitch got a new way to ban people they don't like. Some streamer copyright strike them.
They don't even need to, man. Yo, like I just explained. If they think they can get away with banning someone without reason, like they did to me, or they thought they could, then they do it. They don't need a reason. And they don't have to tell you why. Trains, the Midosuji line. That's funny. To wrap up no later than 2 o'clock, so yeah, we gotta hurry. I do have other stuff going on this week for the next couple days. Hopefully it showed you the outside camera when it went to the Be Right Back scene. I didn't double check. This is kind of our first time with it truly automated now. It did? Okay, cool. The stream connection from the house seems pretty good right now. Like, once it hits 6 p.m., it bombs hard. I can tell, like, the network's not really built for the amount of users that are on it. so the stream gets really shit.
But oh fuck, I'm bleeding bad again.
Thank you.
I wiped down the railing at least. I didn't like do it perfectly on the entire thing, but kind of just cleaned around where I dry my clothes. I don't have the Boosty Board app, no. When I first got the boards, the app was only on iPhone, but it is on Android now, I just never got it. And, of course, I don't have my iPhone anymore, so. Yearly reminder that Monster Cat does not DMCA or copyright strike people's content. I did not know that. But I think we still need permission to play their music, so that's kind of confusing. Amazon sues former AWS marketing VP Brian Hall after he takes a job with Google for their cloud stuff. Where is Jeff Bezos these days? Can he come and save us yet? We're waiting. Rita has my iPhone, yeah. Like an iPhone 7 or something. See that Minneapolis is going to get rid of its police force? That's pretty crazy. Not yet, but over time, there won't be any police left in their city until they create new police again. Which reminds me of Pontiac, because Pontiac, where I used to work with HP, doesn't have its own police force either. So, I don't know if it's a problem or not. So, like, if police are ever needed in Pontiac, they'll send state police. So it's not that police can't go there, but it's the state is sending them. They're not paid by the local city. So like, state police could still go to Minneapolis, I believe. It's just their local workforce, locally employed ones are gonna be gone. it's not like it's going to be anarchy in the city. The state still is there. But crazy nonetheless. Good place for criminals to migrate to, full of criminals anyway. Yeah, exactly like Pontiac, man. There's criminals there either way. City did that? Well, yeah, that's why no one wants to live in Pontiac either. No offense to Minneapolis. I can say whatever I want about Pontiac, though, because that's where I'm from. But, yeah, normally if it gets to the point where there's no police, no one wants to live there anyway. It's already a piece of shit. So, yeah. He is bad, man. Police brutality. I'd like to speak to the manager of systemic racism, please. Karens unite. That's a good meme. City still hasn't come back since then, in my opinion, but maybe it has. Maybe there wasn't a whole lot going on in the first place. We weren't alive then, so it's kind of hard to tell. But there's some good food places now. Yeah, good food. okay for one person. It's perfect for one person. My girlfriend in Korea stayed with me a lot of the time, and it was even smaller than that, and we still managed, so. Maybe it's kind of, like, difficult to see, but, it is possible to live with someone else in a smaller space. I've done it before. People out here are kind of used to that kind of living anyway. So, like, it's nothing to be embarrassed about. I used to be embarrassed about it. Like, be embarrassed about living in such a smaller place than what I'm used to and then having my girlfriend over, but I'm definitely over it now. Because they're used to it too. That's just what life is like out here. I miss her, man. It's perfect for one person and 18 bags of luggage. It is. That balcony is way bigger than I thought it was. God bless that balcony. I want to put some AstroTurf down and get like a small table and chair. So we could like sit outside there at the beginning of the stream during the sunrise at like, well, the sunrise is at 4:30 in the morning, so maybe not at sunrise, but like sip some coffee while like the sun is setting. That would be nice. I need to buy an iron. Yo, if we're gonna have a night stream this weekend and I really want to, I need to buy an iron for my shirt. Or I'm gonna have a very wrinkly shirt. Yeah, I know. Look how far we are. Look how much farther we have to go. What? This train will go no further than this station? I paid for the apartment through the end of August. Can I extend it? Well, I guess I have to ask to find out. But, anything's possible. Just not certain. It's too early, too soon to inquiry about that. I need to see how these next 3 months, 2 or 3 months go. Like, if the end of August rolls around and, like, things are great, life's great here, and the streams are doing good, then, yeah, I'll probably ask if I keep the same place and renew. I would try to. Gorgon just skipped it 3 subs. One to Sofa King, one to Ibrakadabra. One to have no ammo. No ammo, bro. Thank you, Gorgon.
Team just gifted 3 subs.
Yes, rub my forehead. That feels good. Dude, I gotta go to the bathroom now after that coffee. Thank you. right direction?
Yes.
Landlord owns the entire building? Tell. I don't know for sure. It could be someone subletting. I mean, I have like the official manual and documents that match the building, but I have no way to prove that they didn't just get it from someone else. It's possible, yeah.
Especially in Osaka, although it's more and more common with Airbnb. The agents have like listings all over the damn city. So this is one of those agents that has listings everywhere. I don't know if we'll have time to like really adventure the indoor stuff because I'm going to try and do the outside stuff today. Looking extra white today? Dude, I thought so too, man. I've been going tanning at my gym and like just not good beds or balls and has zero effect on me. And I tried a different tanning salon too, and same thing. Really shit quality. So I don't know whether or not I should like keep paying for that stuff when like it barely does anything. That's kind of a bummer. It's very expensive too. See anything fresh and new tech that the West hasn't seen yet? Nope. Nah, there's no special technology out here that other places don't have. Triple coat spray tan. I can't find that here. I don't know where to go. the Trump tan. Oh, yeah, that stuff. True, I haven't used that, like, self-tanner stuff on my face in, well, since I moved. That only lasts, like, a day, so. That stuff is so bad, though. Is it true that Japan will pay half price for your plane tickets? No, you can't enter Japan right now. It's not true. High-tech toilets? I guess? That's not new, man. I had high-tech toilets in Taiwan. You can get those anywhere. That is no longer special. To me. Kind of expected everywhere. Some in the States. I don't use the bidet stuff anyway. It's just nice in the winter time when it's freezing and the toilet seat is heated. That's the best thing. But like right now, you want to turn that off right now, it's too hot. Fucking, you have GTL with no tea? Well, I've been doing the tea, you just can't tell, it's just not good. Been doing at Gold's Gym. I don't know, man. I don't have a solution. So your toilet played copyright music. We're shutting it down. Some toilets play audio, but not music. Like running water sound to muffle the sound of your pee, so that no one can hear you pee. Invented them just like bullet trains. Every country out here has bullet trains. So, yeah, I've been going on bullet trains since 12 years ago, man. Those are not new. Play pee sounds to muffle pee sounds. Yeah, it must be like a waterfall sound or something like that. Mine doesn't have that. I wish it did because there's no real door on my bathroom. So like, if I have a guest over at my tiny place, we're gonna hear each other shitting. There's no way around it. Maybe that's when I turn on Alexa. Alexa, play the news. Dude, my Korean girlfriend was so weird. I'd be like sitting down on my toilet, preparing to take a shit. And then she'd be like running around my apartment, like my entire 10 square feet apartment, in circles. And then like press her face up against the glass to like try and watch me. I think she might have had this fascination watching a Western guy go poop. Maybe. we were into weird shit like that, so, you know, comes with the territory. Just gotta accept it for what it is. Because my bathroom door was glass, so, like, yeah, you can see through. Why the strangers and pandas seem to be leading the world for new tech? Is it the same across the world, too? I don't know, man. We've observed that it's quite the opposite, that Japan is actually behind in tech compared to countries now. Maybe like 20 years ago they were ahead, but it's gone the other direction. Everyone else has caught up or passed them. Internet being the biggest one, but cellular technology overall, it's behind everyone else. I'd say it's even behind the US. CJ dates girls who are into scat? Oh, is that what it's called? I have a smoking girl fetish. That's true. I really love a Korean girl who smokes cigarettes. Yeah. I don't know yet about Japanese girls smoking cigarettes because I never seen one yet. Actually, I don't think I've seen one. You'll post them on the channel? Okay. I gotta pay attention to where we are. Let's see. Oh, wow. Get off at the next station. I think I checked. Transfer to a monorail for two stations. So use the restroom there. That is a very specific fetish, CJ. Well, isn't that the very definition of fetish? And it's not a fetish, man. It's just a turn-on. When you see a hot girl smoking a cigarette, you know, it just makes you want to make out with them, you know? You like the bad girls. Maybe that's it. Goddamn. Yeah, my Korean girlfriend smoked way too many cigarettes. She'd always be like, I'm leaving. Like, where are you going? Oh, right, to smoke again. You were just smoking 10 minutes ago. After any little activity, like washing the dishes, have to go smoke after that. Taking a shower, have to go smoke after that. Stop smoking so much, goddammit. Cigarettes are expensive. And she didn't have a job either, so I don't know where she get the money for that shit. Well, she did She was working, but not full time, I guess. Part time convenience store. You haven't seen me drink beer. It's 11 in the morning, man. Or you just mean in general. In Russia, cigarettes are only $2. Oh. Interesting. Oh, we got a transfer here. Sweet. Let's find a bathroom, man. My bladder is exploding. Oh yeah, you would think everyone here smokes. And they do, but they don't. Right? At least you don't see it. I think it's just because no one's coming outside still. We don't see it. Like, the city's still pretty empty. I mentioned twice yesterday, like, when I was leaving my apartment to go buy more trash bags. Like, I keep seeing these super hot, tatted up chicks in my elevator. And I think to myself, like, why don't we see these people during any of the streams or during the day, like, anywhere? Where's everyone hiding? Everyone's hiding at home, basically. No one wants to go outside still. They have McDonald's breakfast? No. No, I had a half a can of beans. You know what? I probably have to add money to my card, honestly. Oh. Okay, I have to add, just not to get up. We have to get on a different train. The Osaka monorail. Interesting. That implies it's above ground, doesn't it? Is he a bathroom? Where the fuck are we?
We're lost in Japan, man.
Let's see. You are here. Okay. You are here. Okay, I see the restroom. I'm going for it. Follow me. I have no idea where we are. I don't know what the name of the station is. I don't know the name of the town or the city or what's going on. So what I'm trying to say is I'm a lousy tour guide. CJ Tours, welcome. This must be Pachinko since there's so much anime. To go far from the train station now. Go to Pachinko. Alright, here's the bathroom, so I'm gonna put you up against the wall. Watch my skateboard for me. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. I'll be pretty quick.
on the monorail.
The wall looks dirty, like someone spit tobacco on the floor. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Why would he leave his valuables unattended?
Well, because there's no one here. Who's gonna take it?
Plus, you are a live stream. I can just open up the stream. Normally, I watch the stream while I'm like in the bathroom or something. Then I can see right when something happens, if something happens. Monorail should be up here. Can I get a scorp? Area. Huh. Okay. What area of Japan have you visited so far? So far, Osaka. And Kobe and Nara. I was hoping to go to Kyoto this week, but it's gonna rain, so let's not do that.
Area of Japan that you have visited so far strikes you as most ecological wild.
Ecological wild?
Nara. It's got all the animals. And it's got the forest. Kobe might have the hiking trails on those mountains, but the Nara forest is way bigger. They're just different. Both good though.
This building must be really old. I haven't seen a structure like that in a long time.
You ever get tired of Asian countries? You ever went to Europe, Africa, Australia, Asian fetish can't be that bad, is it?
You're a dick, man. Why do you have to be a dick? What did I do to you? Just because I came here learning Chinese doesn't give you the right to be a dick. What the fuck, dude? But I did get yellow fever while in Malaysia, I think, when I got bit by mosquitoes. I had something very bad. Some of the worst pain of my life. Is that on? Everyone loves dick. Oh, wow, that's a lot of dicks in chat. Yeah.
Okay. All fare information will be displayed in English.
How do I do this? Is shaking. Please close the shutter. What the fuck? What kind of technology is this? This is weird. Oh my god, I don't have much cash. Ooh, I almost don't have enough to get home. Okay, that's $20. Enough for today's trains. Now what? But I have no cash left, so... don't forget, I guess. That thing's funny. Yeah, it's like microwaving my cart. Yeah, yellow fever is painful. That's why I was hoping I already had corona, but I'm sure it was just malaria or something else. Which is also not very good sounding, is it? Dang mosquitoes, man. Japanese magic? Yo, that guy asked. Which technology out here is super advanced? I would say that machine we just used. That's the first time I've ever seen that. Train card microwave. Okay, this way to the monorail. Yes. See what's going on. The Expo Park.
Where are we going? Expo 70 commemorative park and mall and place.
That's a mouthful.
Platform 1. Maybe I can stream with Kana? Who's Kana? What you talking about? You guys can't just assume I know everybody. Who the fuck's that? Are they a streamer? This is an interesting station. Windows in. Kana gang? I don't think we have any Kana gang. Are you sure? Press 1 if you're a Kana gang. Press 2 if you have no idea what we're talking about. I think there's only going to be 2 people. How would you describe the old tech aesthetic of Japan? Old tech aesthetic? What do you mean? 111-222-02111. Okay, I guess the Kana gang is pretty big. She's Jake's friend. I don't know all of Jake's friends. Where am I from? Just hit up the where command. She's Rob CD's friend? Oh, okay. I'll ask Rob then. Gotcha! Does this Kana live at Expo Park far north Osaka? Is that why you said that? Serious question, I don't know. Where am I going? It's in the title, Choa. I also tweeted out the Google Map link if you want to see on the map. I don't remember the full name. It's really long. She's in Tokyo? Okay. Gotcha. never hung out with anybody since I arrived. Maybe like once a week. Not very often, man. I'd say probably once a week. Schedule something to do. No, not going to Kyoto today. Although we're not terribly far from it. First time on a monorail? Might be. Since coming here, I mean. In Malaysia, we would ride the monorail almost every day. This one's pretty big. These cars are huge for a monorail. Possibly bigger than the regular trains, actually. Gorgon gifted a sub to Kana Gang TV. Oh, is that her channel? Oh. Thank you, man. No more song. Yeah, we got that DMCA strike. No, I'm just kidding. No sounds while on the train. Yeah. People riding it than I thought. Got a good commute crowd. What place am I hoping to check out while in Japan? Just Kyoto is left. Been everywhere else that I can reach. Can you see? No, the blinds are down. I'm not gonna let you too close to the girl next to me. You're staying over here with me on my lap. Any monuments in particular you'd be interested in seeing? Nope. I don't think so. I don't really know what there is.
Although I picked out some for us to see today. Some monuments that are kind of crazy looking. We're at Bumpaku Kinin Koen. Gamba Osaka. Yeah, looks like a football team. Are they famous for football over here? Did I just seriously call it football? I meant soccer. I'm sorry. Oh, wow. We might have a view on this side. Expo City. Alright, there's the giant indoor mall activity place. And there's also a giant park. Oh my god, I can see one of the monuments. Wow, it's a lot bigger than I thought.
Is the Olympics still going ahead in Japan?
Yeah, next year. Is a giant wooden ball. Cool how they cut the wood. Oh, here's their soccer team. Sponsored by Panasonic.
Okay, 250,
20, 5, 6. I'd like 650 to get here. Alright. Ah, the full name of this place, Expo 70. Commemorative park. But it's not all a park. That is. Okay. Try this way.
Yes, he does. Googled big boy restaurants in Japan. Oh, yeah? There's some in Hokkaido? Ah. That's cool. I think you need an airplane to get there from here, man.
Subscribe for free with Twitch Prime.
Yeah, I wonder if that's an expo center, maybe. They call this mall place Expo City. And there's a Ferris wheel. And I want to go to the other side. So, must be bridge access somewhere. Oh wow, this is a good view of that crazy looking guy. I have no idea what he stands for yet. Look at the monorail. It's like a roller coaster thing.
Here we go. Osaka Expo Park is a massive park and recreational facility that was created on the site of the 1970 Japan World Exposition. Ah, oh, so they call it Expo 70. That was a long time ago. That was 50 years ago. I don't really know what that is, though. Your dad went to it? Really? Wow. Well, this is definitely a big name place. Everyone here will know about it.
Tell us about the 70s, CJ.
Yo, fuck you, man. I'm only 23. I wasn't alive then. Yeah, I kinda wanna go up there. I don't know. Apparently they have a VIP car that you can get with your lover and not have to share with other people. VIP Ferris wheel ride for $80. Okay. Might try and go in this place for some ramen or something later. I want to see if it's worth coming back another time when it's like rainy and stuff outside. First this morning, let's head over to the actual outdoor park. Beast. What is that? Playground thing? I have no idea what that is. Expo 70 Commemorative Park. Okay. This way. Pretty big wheel. That's pretty big. Yeah, it's going right now. It's open. Thank you. Okay. Oh, I didn't know we have to buy a ticket. Okay. I don't have cash. Uh-oh. Tower of the Sun. Ah, oh, that's what he's called. Alright. Oh, wow. I didn't know all this stuff was inside it. It's like a mini amusement park to explore. No? Okay. Okay. Alright, thanks. Which price do we pay? Maybe that's just for the internal exhibits. Just wanted to see what there was first. CJ Walk returns. See you on the second stream. Where did that guy come from? Really snuck up on me. He's a ninja from 1970. That's right. Oh, fuck me, man. Wait. Do I pay? Failed to understand that there was an entrance fee, and now I don't have cash because I spent it all on the train pass. Can see if they take credit card here. Hi. Yeah, do you take credit card?
Yeah.
Only cash?
Cash only.
Okay, alright, thank you. Okay, change of plans. We're going into that building today. I can't get in. I can't get in. Fuck. ATM? Vending machines? Nah. Alright, take a picture of the big statue guy. The Expo 70 commemorative park was developed on the site of the Exposition Center to mark the success of the Japan World Exposition. Still don't know what that is. Held in 1970 as the first international exposition in Asia. Exposition of what? The exposition themed on progress and harmony for mankind. Oh, okay. Had a total of 116 unique pavilions, including 84 by exhibitors that included 76 countries and 4 international organizations, 32 by Japanese exhibitors, including the Japanese pavilion. Oh, okay. The most significant event in the history with the Japanese garden placed on the north side of the expo with the amusement park Expo Land, and on the south side attracted 64 million visitors in 183 days. That's a lot of people. The National Cultural Gardens serve as the vital part of the Expo 70 commemorative park, which is developed on a 260-hectare-acre expo site. Okay. 50,000 trees. 25 times the size of Koshin Stadium. I'm not sure where that is. Flowers bloom throughout the year in the gardens. Yeah, a lot of nature stuff inside. Obviously a couple museums. There's like some neat playgrounds and shit you can ride. Habitat for over 70 species of birds, insects, fish, shellfish.
Okay.
There you go.
Learned something. I didn't know it was that important. That was that big.
Wow.
It's a big statue.
The Eiffel Tower in Paris was also a building for an expo. Oh, I didn't know that. For a World Expo theme.
Oh, interesting. No wonder. You can see some of the aging on the stations over here. Like, yeah, this stuff's been around a long time. I have to carry cash in Japan. I did. I had $20. I already spent it.
So many roads too.
Wow, wow, wow.
Hop the fence? Dude, the ninja guy already came up to us. He's watching the fence. A 1970s ninja. You can see some of the stuff that you can play on over there.
Sure, it's too far for the camera.
Interesting.
Expo City.
I'm sure this place came after the fact.
Yeah, I think so. Try coming again another time. While they get some cool pictures too. It was as cool as the waterfalls the other day. Damn. Sorry, man. It's just not working out for me, is it?
Not working out for you either.
We're all getting screwed. Go watch a movie at the IMAX.
Looks popular with geriatrics. CJ's people.
Hello. What? Yeah.
What do you?
This? This?
No. Here is...
Yeah. Okay.
Camera.
Yeah.
No?
Yes.
Oh,
okay.
Okay.
All right. I'll go. Thanks. Okay. You know what? There's nobody here anyway. I'm leaving. Basically, everyone told me I can't do anything. Okay. Time bring a Scooty Puff? What's that? A scooter? Well, we have Family Mart. And some egg-shaped trees over there. Those look kind of funny. Giant Easter eggs. We could do Family Mart mukbang. This one's big. Basically did it last night. I've been doing it the past two nights because I've been having dinner around midnight. So it's like too late to cook. So I end up buying a whole bunch of things from Family Mart or 7-Eleven. Last night's was actually pretty good. should come back with a skateboard while you're riding around on a bike. Thank you, man. That's funny. Pretty big area. Alright, I'm just gonna get back on the train because... Yeah, sorry about that. It was not the plan. I don't think there's anything else over here. Like, these are the main attractions for this particular station. No, I'm good. Hey, my blood is drying. Yippee. Don't need a band-aid. There's so many tracks. Where is this train going?
something to eat. I had breakfast at home. Right before I started streaming.
I had half a veggie sushi roll and half a can of beans. Johnny, she was from Jeju, so I didn't get to see her very often, just whenever she could like make time to fly to Seoul. I'm still gonna wait to see if I hear back from the guy on Twitter, the developer of the DMCA program. And check briefly to see if I can make my own program as well. Most of the top clips we actually already have downloaded because we used to have them play during the Be Right Back scene. So I think they're actually saved on a hard drive somewhere in my luggage on the balcony. Except for anything recent, I guess I won't have. Old stuff I do have. I'm going to go to the next one. clips and VODs are already well long gone and cleaned up.
Oh, my head! Yeah, I definitely would have been concerned about those clips for music, I think. Just because I wouldn't be able to remember what happened. But they're already gone. I think. You never know.
There could be some stuck out there. It's impossible to, like, check them all. But maybe I got it.
Shabbat.
Zai走路换火车少坐捷运 Okay, here's our anime picture of the day. This lady, Toyokawa. Am I deleting the clip? No. My account will be banned before I delete that. That was the best day of my life. Seen the slums? You must have missed the streams by my house, man. I live right next to the slums. It's the Skid Row of Osaka. It's literally people living on the street. Picking through garbage stuff, things that people don't want anymore. So they have some like big recycling centers over there or something, so they like hang out there and take anything that's still usable. I can't delete 1,000 of partners overnight. Well, I don't think anyone's been banned yet, right? So far, no one's gotten more than 2 strikes. Which is kind of suspicious. It's like the DMCA people know how far to push people without getting them banned yet. Maybe. Just enough to make people worry. Something's fishy. It's not the sushi. What is this place? Comfortable sports place? Space? Nice. This is Starbucks. I don't really know what that is. So far, yes? Okay. Smaller ones probably have? I mean, that's you just saying something that you can't deny or confirm. I'm sure if it happens to smaller streamers, we'll hear about it and pick it up somehow, because someone will share it with train wrecks and then everyone will know. I don't think it's happened yet. We would know, man. All right, peace, Grovelar.
Good time chatting, man.
Alright, this building definitely looks 1970s. I don't know what it looks like. I feel like I'm in a time machine though. Did they go over IRL music playing? I didn't see anything, man, and no one wrote back to me, no one responded. Didn't see any clips of it. So, not sure. I didn't watch their whole broadcast. Miss my morning tai chi. Well, we can do it on the balcony every morning if you want. My sword is packed away though. Probably not enough room to swing it around though. Yeah, we could certainly try. It's sort of hard to do without someone leading, though. That's my problem, is I can't really lead. I can follow, though. It's a small world after all. Oh, we can never go to the grocery store again. Who owns the Happy Birthday song? Does Disney own that? Might be Disney.
ones to watch out for.
Axel Mania 2K
with the Prime sub.
Merry to month. What's going on, man? Appreciate it very much.
Axel Mania 2K just subscribed.
Loteria. Oh my god. You don't see many of those over here for some reason. Have to really look for them. Oh, they can't enforce happy birthday anymore? That's good.
Actually, we did walk by a couple bakeries, surprisingly. I don't see them too often, but there was a couple out there at that plaza space. We saw some really, really good bakeries in Nara. It's something I noticed. Like, that place kind of exceeds in the food and drink department over other nearby areas. Where are you going? Back to Osaka City, downtown? Just going back now. Too far away. The deer. Yeah. Really is a good pull for them, isn't it? I guess so. The deer made that city. Or the tourism anyway.
Oh, really? I saw on YouTube this morning that Texas was getting worse. Yeah, I'm good. I'm just reading my phone. I'm reading through the COVID-19 Nomad Network. People are like posting updates for everywhere basically, so you can kind of follow what's going on if you're traveling or stuck somewhere.
realize I went overboard with the junk food over the weekend and while moving, but that's because I was moving, man. I didn't have time or opportunity to cook, so I want to lay off of it for a while. Cook for myself again. I had a hot dog burrito. Did they have one Monday night? Wait, Monday night was last Sunday night? I had one at like 1 in the morning. Actually, tonight is Italian night. We're having Italian food. See something. I'd like to know more myself. It's interesting. shields up.
Subscribe for free with Twitch Prime.
Raise the shields.
Switch. Yeah, you can hear the plastic bags. I tried to tape them down so that they're not as loud. It is a problem. It's just so windy outside all the time.
I can't see behind me.
Damn, that place was really far, wasn't it?
DIY cardboard PC case. I'm gonna have to find directions tonight if someone's got like dimensions kind of laid out.
good, man.
Nice guy.
Oh. Yeah, I think so, Chua. Grab an empty backpack. See what's over here. I'm gonna go do some grocery shopping, but probably off camera next. Take care of that jazz. Probably won't be able to night stream tonight, so I'm unlikely to be back until tomorrow morning.
Oh, Claude, dude, sorry I didn't get a chance to write you back, man. I haven't had a minute to rest. Shit. Still gotta go through some DMs. My bad, dude. I will check while I'm riding to the train, probably. To the gym in a couple hours or something. I'll have a chance then when I'm on the train again. Yeah, I don't want to get hit with the copyright strike from the grocery store music. That's true. But it'd be really fucking funny if it happened. Funny for the internet, not so funny for me. Alright, we're rating Sailor Salty. Looks like she's doing something IRL-esque. Something in her house. So, enjoy. Have a good rest of the day. I'm gonna go shopping. Just drop off a couple things, get my empty bag. So, talk to you guys later. Thanks. Bye.